here, you can kind of see some of what I'm doing here. So with at my church, we have some macros that change the look for the live stream to a different lower third. So we use a different background on every song. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, macros, collections, and icons best practices. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if your macros are just all kinds of disorganized and you look at a slide with the macro on it and you're like, I have no idea what that's going to do until I click on it, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments below. And while you're at it, go ahead, like this video, subscribe, and share it with others who might find it interesting. So this is one of those things. There's some things that you really, until you're doing it, you just miss some of the finer things. In my former church, which unfortunately closed down, I was mostly running a camera or directing. I didn't use ProPresenter as much. I think that they kind of thought that that would be boring to me. It's not, of course. I love ProPresenter. But with that said, I would always help the person that was running ProPresenter if they had a question or something like that. Well, in my current church, they know that this is what I do. So I've been running ProPresenter, and I've run into a couple of little things. In a previous tutorial, I told you about best practice for arrangements of having a default arrangement and a master arrangement as a bare minimum. But the other thing that I've learned, and I started doing this at my church, is first off, I taught them about macros. And if you don't know what a macro is, then I'll try and remember to leave a link with this tutorial to the tutorial on what macros are. But in recent times, Renewed Vision has added in a couple of features that make it very helpful for macros. So let's head over to the computer and we'll take a look. Right here, you can kind of see some of what I'm doing here. So at my church, we have some macros that change the look for the live stream to a different lower third. So we use a different background on every song, and we do a different lower third on every song. So it could be that they have a different font, or there's a little still image behind the lower third that's a little bit different. Either way, a little bit different. So this is actually an example of what I'm doing here. So I have put in one for one and two for two. Let me explain. So we have these different worship lower third looks. So if I right click on it here, let me hide myself real quick, and I add an action to it. Basically what it would be doing is it would be an audience look change, where I might have 10 different worship lower third looks where the in-person congregation, they get, it's always the same amongst all those. But for the live stream audience, they're going to get a different lower third for each song. So I might change it here. And since each of those is just numbered, I just decided to right click, go down to change icon, and change it to a number. And I think that that's a better way to do it. I mean, if I look here, notice that I can just glance at that and know that I'm on number one. So that's pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and remove that as well. I have another one here, my default collection here, and I have this audio fade. And when I am fading, so what this is it will just fade the audio layer right here. And why I have that is here. So the action is, let's...
Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person.
See, it's a clear audio action right there. That's the action that I have. So to make that a little bit easier, I'm going to change this icon to that same icon as this, so that that helps me know, okay, that is the audio fade macro. Maybe I want to change the color as well. Contrasting colors are better, but that's another helpful thing to do. Now, for these, I've got one for the downstream key to on, one for downstream key to off, the control my ATEM Television Studio HD, one that turns on the default look. Maybe I want to right click and change the icon for that one to D for default. Okay, and when I do that, I know, and it changed up here, because when you change it here, every slide that it changes to changes. It has the macro on it. It changes automatically. So that is helpful as well. So that's good to go. So another thing that I have done is I have organized those into different collections. And I've already shown you these collections. I've got one for that's my default collection here, one that's for my worship lower thirds. If you saw my Jeopardy tutorial, collections are really helpful for that, because look at all these macros here. Let me hide myself again. Look at all these macros. That is just way too many to have mixed in with stuff that I do every week, since this is a rare thing that I do, is play Jeopardy. So that's helpful. One thing that I did with this is I went ahead and I made one that is just for the worship lower thirds. That's one collection. Then I have like a we use these every week collection, which is like the first slide of the first worship song, which makes sure that we've got the stage screen set up correctly, make sure that the looks are correct, etc. So instead of having to add all of those every week, we just have that macro, and it can do all those actions all at once. So I've kind of divided them like that, based on how we use it. One, if we use it every week, it's going to be in the weekly. If it's just the worship lower thirds, it's in the worship lower thirds. Maybe I would have one that is just for the sermon and some different things there. So maybe I have some alternate themes for the live stream based on what type of content. So scripture content might need a different lower third, or maybe it needs to go full screen, something like that, than a bulleted list or a short quote. So that's the kind of stuff that I want to advise you to change to make it, first off, change the icon to make it more obvious at a glance what it's doing. Secondly, organize it into collections. Think of them kind of like folders for these macros so that you can just know where to find them if you have more than one or two. You know, if you only have two macros and that's all you're ever going to use, no biggie. But when it comes to, even in my church, which isn't a huge church, there's less than 200 people, we still have a good number of macros now that I've shown them what macros do. So that's a helpful thing to do as well. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/ProQuick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for it for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.